everybody, this is Leon Hilbert, aka the Professor, and I would like to welcome you to my tutorial. Today we're going to be going over how to mod a custom character into Sonic Racing Cross Worlds. This tutorial is going to be broken up into several different parts to make it much easier for you to find the exact part of the tutorial that you're looking for. You can follow along with this tutorial by going to my Google Doc, which has all of the exact same instructions as these videos. The videos will just hopefully help show you exactly what it looks like to follow the instructions. In this tutorial series, I'll be putting one of my original characters over Miku. We will be extracting the files from the game, rigging the character, adding animations, replacing the voice files, replacing the subtitles, and then we will be packing it into the game using Unreal Editor. This is the only video on this series that will have an introduction like this at the beginning. All the other videos will get straight into the tutorial. In this first video, we're going to start by downloading FModel, the mapping file, setting up FModel, and making it so that we can extract the files from the game. So let's get started with that. Alright, here we are looking at the dock. The very first thing that we're going to do is download FModel and the mapping file. Okay, now we'll go and download the mapping file. And now we're gonna go to our downloads. The first thing you want to do, of course, is extract FModel. And I'm gonna say this several times in this tutorial. Make a modding tools folder to put all of your different tools in. This is gonna help keep you organized and make sure you don't lose anything. So now we're going to go to FModel and open it. So whenever you first open up FModel, it's going to look like this. You're gonna have this little window and you're going to want to select the game. Now, how do you find the game directory? Go to Steam. Then click on Sonic Racing Cross World, right click it, go to Manage, go to Browse Local Files, and this directory up here at the top, copy and paste that, and you're going to click those three little dots, and then you're going to copy and paste this into the directory, and then click Select Folder, and then you're going to make sure that you have UE5_4 selected, because Sonic Racing Cross Worlds uses Unreal Engine 5.4. And you challenge something, so it's gonna restart, and there you go, you should start. I have a bunch of mods here, so that's why those are at the top down here, and you're gonna notice that you can't open them. It's gonna say, could not load virtual paths, plugin, manifest may not exist. So you're going to go to settings. First of all, you're going to go down here to local mapping file and select enabled. And then you're going to click these three little dots and you're going to choose your mapping file. Go to your modding tools, select the Cross Worlds release.us map. And we're not done here in the settings yet. First, go to models. Make sure that your mesh format is set to actor X and in parentheses PSK, PSKX, and make sure that you do not export bone sockets, and click OK. Now, it's still not ready, because you need the AES key. As I understand it, this is the key by which your system is able to read the files which are encrypted. So you're going to go up here to directory, AES, and you're going to copy and paste the AES key that is in the description and in my tutorial doc. Press OK. Now, you're going to be able to access these files. To start off with, if you are wanting to replace a character, most of the characters are located in PackChunk 2, the .utok specifically. Some of them are located in different places. Silver and Charmy are located in one of the other pack files. I have those written down in the tutorial doc under the section hack files directory, because it can be very annoying going through each and every one of these, searching through the files, trying to find the character that you're looking for. So make sure to check that out if you can't find your characters. Most of them will be in Pack Trunk 2. Now, most of the cast of characters are going to be in 01 Union, but if you're trying to replace a character such as Miku, Minecraft Steve, or Joker, etc., they're going to be in 02 Union. All of the extended roster characters are in 02 Union. You're going to go to Asset, Character, and all of these are, unlike the original cast, which were named, the extended characters are not named. The way that you find the character that you're looking for is by opening one of these, going to Texture, and viewing the texture. Now you can see that extended character 4 is Minecraft Steve. The next one after him is Alex, so on and so forth. Now Miku is located here, extended character 10. So the file that we need is extended character U asset. That's the only one that you're going to be downloading. You don't need to download the skeleton or the physics assets, because the skeleton is included in the character mesh and you don't need the physics asset. So right click on the character and select save model. Now this may take a moment, but this is going to be saved right here, and you can find it by going to your fmodel folder, go to output, and go to exports. Now, I couldn't tell you why, but sometimes it appears in Union, sometimes it appears in game. Right now, it seems to want to put it in game, so that's where it's putting it. So, it's going to appear here, and it's going to appear as a .psk. Next, we're going to extract. Unless you are editing the existing textures, you don't need to extract them, nor do you need to extract any of these if you're replacing some of the animations, which we are going to test. You will go to the animation folder, you will select the animation that you want to export, and you're gonna select save animation. Now you can do this in bulk by clicking one, holding down shift, and clicking one at the bottom. And then you can click save animation, and I'll save all of them. That will take longer to do, but it will work. And that is located in the exact same file location under animation. Next, I'm going to show you how to extract the character's voice lines. So Miku's voice lines are located here in Pack Trunk 50. Make sure you have the .pack, not the .utop. So under .pack, under Cryware Data, we're going to be looking for Extend 10. She only has a .acb file and not a accompanying .awb. That is fine. Thubar will be able to read this, and we'll talk more about Thubar later on. So you're going to right click, and this time you're going to select export raw data, and this one will be located in Union content Cryware data, and there it is. So that is the end of the first tutorial in the series. I hope that it was helpful. Feel free to ask me any questions in the comments, and I will try to get to them as quickly as possible. You can also contact me at the Crossworld Hub Discord server at the Sonic Prof. There'll be a link to that in the description. Anyways, I hope that this tutorial is helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next video. You're dismissed.